Isn't it great to see a packed barn?
You know it is.
I'm glad fans are back in the building. It started to get too loud in there.
Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little ridiculous.
Good boy.
Play all the hits! Left Toronto Maple Leafs. So let me finish. How am I supposed to go to bed after watching that?
I'm quite hyped. With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
What was that? Leafs lose 5-1 to the Buffalo Sabres. Listen. You're not gonna win every game. And listen, generally speaking, losses are bad. You don't wanna lose. But there are some losses where you're like, I wish they hadn't, but You're not gonna win every game. You know what? At least they showed some fight. You know what? They fell behind early, but they clawed back. You know what? They almost blew a lead, but they bent and didn't break. This game had no redeeming features. None. This game was a waste of all of our time. All of us are worse off for having watched this game. We're all worse people with less time to live after watching that. There are Leaf games that bring me a joy, as if from my childhood, that is impossible to replicate. And there are Leaf games that remind me one day I'm gonna go to a funeral not as a guest. That was this game, too dark. Well, it was. Like, dude, it's not even that it's the Sabres, but it's the Sabres! And I did see the logic that, well, it's the Sabres. You know, they save it for the real games, the games that matter, the litmus tests, and they had those recently. Carolina, Minnesota, Washington, Pittsburgh. Buffalo, doesn't matter if you have a bad game against Buffalo. Yes, it does matter if you have a bad game against a divisional rival, especially at home. That performance not being a big deal just tells me you weren't there. If you were there, please leave a comment in the comment box down below. How did you feel? This is the first packed barn since before Christmas. We were given a thing, a beautiful thing, and COVID took it away. And for months, the building anticipation, I can't wait to get back in that building. And the Leafs entice you over the past few months. Hey, you can't wait to get back in that building. Look where we are in the standings. And you can't wait to get back in that building and the tickets go on sale. And you're like, how does that even work? People had tickets and then they don't have tickets. No one knew how it worked. But you were able to get tickets. You were able to find transit. Maybe you had to find babysitting. Make arrangements with friends. Get the night of or morning after off work. And you show up and it's that. For 2.5 hours? And you paid for it! Got the $30 popcorn and the $45 drink! If you're using the standings as a reason why fans booing tonight was wrong, I think you've forgotten about sports and the relationship you're supposed to have with it. It's supposed to make you, like, feel stuff, and you paid to see a good game. You didn't pay to see him win. You're not guaranteed a win. You're not even guaranteed a good game. But you hope for it. You buy a ticket for a top five team. You can certainly hope for it. You can be optimistic for it. You can expect it. And if you took the 3, 4, 5, 6 hours that it takes between getting there, enjoying it, and then going home, if you took all that time, spent over $200, and then go, yeah, but they were good in all the games that I wasn't at, like, really? You think that person exists? If they suck and barely show up to a game that you paid to attend, boo! I think if you waited over 3 months and paid money to be at that game, you have every right to boo. That game had no redeeming qualities, none. The big lineup story heading into the game, besides the fact that Peter Mrazek got the start, is Rasmus Sandin on the right side of Morgan Rielly. It went so poorly that despite the fact that Rasmus Sandin scored a goal for his second consecutive game, by the way, Sheldon Keefe had this to say. Keefe, when asked if he'll stick with the Rielly-Sandin pairing, probably not. Dry. But fair. And it's not like Sandin was the only one. Rielly wasn't very good either. Peter Mrazek, the second goal. Oof, my dog. I said this on the podcast. I think I said it on the stream. He does not know where the goalposts are. He doesn't. I'm gonna start calling him Bungie. He literally, watch him. Watch him and watch the goals he allows. He doesn't know where they are. It's like there are goalies and puck stoppers and he's a puck stopper. Because, like, look, he's been in the NHL for a long time and there's a reason he makes the money that he does. He's stopped a lot of pucks. He's a puck stopper. Goalie? Not like any good goalie I've ever seen. Not in this decade. His rebounds are wild and it's part of the reason why I don't know if he's the greatest match for the Toronto Maple Leafs because, I don't know, they kind of struggle to clear bodies and pucks from the front of their net. But this is what I'm talking about. Look at this. You see the screen grab? All right? The Sabres get a secondary opportunity. This is obviously very, very, very bad in front. No one picks up Olofsson. Sandin, I'm not sure who the forward is. Rielly. No one picks him up. No one's got him. But, can we zoom in on number 35? Get a map! Not a molecule of Bina Mrazek is touching blue paint. Not a molecule. Who told you? They talk about this in Skills? Really? You ever using Google Maps and you take like a U-turn and it completely screws Siri up? In 200 meters, turn left, turn right, make a U-turn, you have arrived. Make a U-turn in 150, that's how he plays net! He's an 8.95 and his record is 9-4, so I don't know either. From Sportsnet Sats, Sabres' Craig Anderson is the first 40 plus year old goalie to face the Maple Leafs since David Ayers on February 22nd, 2020. Mrazek was in that game too. Also, who runs that again? That's unnecessary! Kristen Shilton pointing out that Sheldon Keefe called the 5-2 loss to the Montreal Canadiens recently a wake-up call. Don LeCision pointing out Montreal game was the 8 a.m. alarm. The Detroit game was the 8.09 a.m. alarm after hitting snooze once. The Buffalo game is the 8.18 a.m. alarm after hitting snooze again. Dom, I see we are cut from the same cloth. Like, I guess the reason I'm so mad about this one is what moment in this game would you focus on as, like, a positive? Or like, and then the game sort of got away from it. There are none. It was tied after one, and even the first period sucked. They didn't generate any offense. They didn't generate any anything. Fans booed at the end of the game because it was the first sound they made all game, because it was the first time they had any reason to. Is that Dangle guy blowing a fuse yet? And Mike Zeisberger says, any response, Steve Dangle? I would, Zeis, but that game was like a tranquilizer dart to the neck. I got news for you. Two Red Bulls and a pot of coffee couldn't jazz up a 5-1 loss to the Sabres. No disrespect or anything, but that's a team we should beat, says Rasmus Sandin about the Buffalo Sabres. Now, that's gonna be viewed as a saucy quote. Quite spicy, rather. Bulletin board material for the Buffalo Sabres, and maybe it is. But any cool-headed Buffalo Sabres should be like, yeah, fair. And we're used to seeing the Sabres in 29th, it's just that it's an improvement because there's more teams now. The Sabres have 42 points. The Leafs have 74! Rasmus Sandin was calling out a professional hockey team with that quote, and it wasn't the Sabres. You can't win every game! Jesse, get out of my mentions! Sometimes you need these kinds of games as a wake-up call. So, it's funny. It seems like every time the Leafs just lay an egg, we're gonna bring up that Sheldon Keefe wake-up call comment. And I just want to make sure we're doing it for the right reasons. It shouldn't be to call out Sheldon Keefe like he's dumb. He's not. What he was doing with that quote, oh, it's a wake-up call. Yeah, losing to the Montreal Canadiens. What he was doing with that quote was trying to save their feelings. He's trying to be good cop. Stop. Stop coddling these guys. I think the lesson to be learned here is you look ridiculous when you don't tell the truth. Because the fans, they don't forget. They don't need a wake-up call. They remember. How long until the Leafs trade for James Reimer? Alex, I'm gonna need you to stop. Also, 2 weeks. What's your secret to staying sane? What the hell are you asking me for, Steve? Oh, I don't know, Steve. You seem like the expert. Oh, yeah, do I, Steve? Secret to staying sane? First time? How do I stay sane? Steve, when you find out, why don't you tell me? Okay, I will. Does not help that we have the same name. Congrats on the spelling, though. The rest of you are wrong. I mean, I think we're done. Like, we don't gotta waste much more time on that. They don't play again until Saturday. They have until Saturday to feel bad about that, because they should. That was terrible. And hopefully they're better against the Canucks. 5-1 to the Sabres. You have 2.5 days to get a bungee cord and figure it out. It's the red, mostly square. That's what you, yeah. That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends, if you're a goaltender, tend the goal! It's good to be back.